Hey everybody, what's up? We're talking investment platforms today. I'm going to talk about some of the apps and investment platforms that I use to invest my money and some to trade stocks. So stay tuned and keep watching. Hey everybody, this is Leroy. Thanks for watching and welcome to my channel, 40 and Broke, where we're dedicated to getting out of debt, saving, investing, getting our finances under control so we can finally live the life that we've always dreamed of. I ask that you hit that like button, subscribe to my channel down below to get more content such as this, and thanks for watching. So like I said, we're going to be talking investment platforms, and I want to talk about some of the investment platforms that I have used or that I am using, and then I'll mention some of the platforms that are out there. I've never used them, but I wanted to make you aware of them so that you can make an informed decision on where to put your money and where to invest. So for starters, I am not a financial advisor. I'm just some guy on YouTube talking to you about what I do. And you need to do your own due diligence. So, like I said, these are just my opinions. This is what I do. This is what works for me. Your situation is completely different. So, you want to do your own research. With that being said, let's jump right in. So, for starters, I invest in my company's 401k. They match dollar for dollar up to 3%. So, at the moment, I think I put in 6% of my pay, and then my company matches 3%, so I get that automatic 3% right there, and that's the very first place that I invest. So if you have a company that offers you a 401k or some sort of pension or some sort of retirement plan, I would take them up on it and start as soon as possible. That way, you can get fully invested. And especially if they offer some sort of employee match. So like I said, my employer offers a 3% match. So I take that and that's free money right there. Any employee retirement plan that you have, start by doing that. The first platform that I invest with is M1 Finance. I say hands down, this is my favorite investing platform. I put in a recurring payment bi-weekly, so the Monday after I get paid, money automatically goes into my M1 account. I create what's known as a pie, so I put a certain percentage into each holding into this pie. So the pie equals obviously 100%, so, and then I'll have, you know, say 20% in this ETF or 20% in that bond ETF, you know, maybe 20% in an, you know, E-Rite ETF. I do a lot of ETFs, and most of them in my M1 are designed for dividends. And then the thing about M1 is they will reinvest the dividends. So I don't have to worry about going in and rebuying anything with the dividend money I get. It's automatically reinvested. I love that. The best thing I like about M1 is that I can set it and forget it. It automatically puts whatever percentage I want into each holding. If one holding is underperforming what it's supposed to be, what I want it to be at, it will put money in that holding, and it will ignore the other holdings that are, say, over the percentages. So it does all the work for me. All I have to do is basically nothing. I don't have to do anything. It just takes the money out of my account every Monday after I'm paid. Automatic payment sends the money straight to M1, and they do all the work. At the end of the year, if you want to rebalance your portfolio, there's an option so that you can rebalance it. They have a Roth IRA option. They have an M1 Plus that offers you more services. I simply use the free version of M1. They have, I believe they even have a checking account that offers cash back on purchases and stuff like that. But like I said, I don't use any of that. I just use the investing platform and I absolutely love it. So once again, M1 Finance, it is a great investing platform. Hands down, my favorite, my number one pick for investing my money outside of my 401k. In fact, I like it more than my 401k because I've gotten a better return with M1 Finance than the people running my 401k. If you want to invest with M1 Finance, I've got a link down below. It's a referral link. We'll both get $10 and it doesn't cost you anything. I'm not associated with any of these. It's anything that I tell you that I have a referral link, they're simply just referral links. They're not sponsoring this video, nothing like that. I'm not making a commission from them. Like I said, they're just referral links. So just refer the referral link down below if you want to use M1 Finance. The next investing platform I want to talk about is Acorns. Now, for total disclosure, I do not use Acorns. I had an Acorn account maybe a year or so ago, and then I closed it down. Acorns is not a free account. They cost $1 a month, I believe it was, when I was on the platform. So I ended up shutting it down because there were other accounts out there, such as M1, that's free. So I was like, why would I pay $1 a month in order to have this platform? On the pro side, when I was using it, it was similar to M1 Finance. Now, the only difference was so that every time you swiped your debit card at the store, it would round up the purchase and it would save that in your your Acorns account. And once you got $5, it would invest that $5. Hence the term Acorns. It said from small change, big things grow, therefore from acorns, a mighty oak will grow. So that's their whole point was you can take all this small change that you normally wouldn't have and just round up to the nearest dollar and invest it. And another thing that they had that I really liked, they had a sponsor program where you'd go through these different websites, say, for instance, Liberty Mutual, the insurance company. You could click on these referral links and it would take you over to the Liberty Mutual website and you would get a quote. So if you got an insurance quote through Liberty Mutual, and just by getting the quote, you would get, say, $5 or $10. It was called, I believe, Earned Money. And that was a really cool aspect of what they had. But like I said, there were other free platforms out there, and that's what I switched to. But Acorns was a good platform. It had stuff about it that I really liked. If you like the ease and you like where you can just swipe your card and it rounds up the money, then Acorns might be a good one for you to check out. So now I'm gonna switch gears a little bit and talk about trading platforms. So you have Robinhood. Robinhood, you can buy and sell fractional shares, whereas like M1 and Acorns was more of an investment platform. Robinhood is actually something where you can buy and sell stocks on. You can trade options, you can sell individual stocks, and it was very great for beginners. That's what I use. I don't buy and sell stocks all that much. I'm more of an investor than a trader, but I do like to dabble a little bit into swing trading. So that's what I use my Robinhood app for. Now, Robinhood also has a Robinhood Gold, which I only use the free part of Robinhood. I don't pay for it. I have a few stocks that I dabble in that, just see how they do. And I like Robinhood because it's basic. It's good for beginners. If you have a stock that has a dividend, you can set the dividend reinvestment program so that you don't have to worry about it. It will automatically invest that dividend back into the stock. You're able, like I said, you're able to buy and sell. You can't do day trades. You're only allowed a certain amount of day trades unless you have the, I believe it's $25,000 in your account, which makes you a certified trader or whatever it is. Like I said, I'm not a trader, so I don't know what the terminology is or what the requirements are to be a day trader, because I am definitely not that. However, I do like to do a swing trade every now and then, speculate, and I use Robinhood to play around with the stock market when I want to do some speculation, stuff like that. So it's very beginner friendly, and that's what I like about it the most. There's a lot of stocks, ETFs, different commodities to choose from. It's just easy to use. Now, the downside is it has been known to lag, and it also has been known to crash. So if it's something that you want to be real serious about trading, you might want to look towards a different platform. But if swing trading is your thing, then it's not too bad. If it's something and you're just a beginner and you want to start learning, Robinhood's a good app for that. And once again, I have a referral link down below if you want to use that to set up a Robinhood account. And then we'll both get a free stock for using that referral link. The next platform is Webull. Now, Webull is Robinhood on steroids. It is extremely advanced. It's, well, I don't know about extremely, but it is advanced. I would say that there's more tools and there's just more aspects to it. If you're into, you want to take trading seriously, Webull is the way to go. It's what my brother uses. He's a swing trader, and it's what he uses with his swing trades and the different trades he makes. So he likes it because there are numerous charts you can set up, all the different aspects that you need for it. And it gives you news, it gives you breakdowns. I opened a Webull account. In fact, like I say, I have a referral link down below that will give you, I believe, two free stocks right now if you use the referral link. Trading stocks is something you would take seriously, then I would recommend Webull. Like I said, I do not take it seriously. I'm more of an investor with, and I dabble in swing trades. So to me, Webull was a bit more advanced than I needed, so I just stuck with Robinhood. But if there's a lot of analysis or stock analysis that I want to do, things I really want to look up, then I will go on the Webull platform and I'll use the Webull to do the stock analysis. But on the downside, one of the reasons I did not like the Webull, they do not offer fractional shares. Robinhood, I can buy fractional shares, whereas with Webull, I have to pay for the full share. There's no fractional shares in that. So that was a downside to Webull. But like I said, everything else made up for it. If trading stocks is something you're thinking about doing, seriously, then I would definitely recommend Webull. And if you want to use Webull, like I said, I've got that referral link down below, and we'll both get a free stock, I think, just for signing up. And then I think it's another free stock or maybe two free stocks when you fund the account. And I think you have to put $100 in it or something. I'm not sure exactly how much money had to go in it. And very good for a free app. So, all right. So those are what I have. Those are the ones that I have either invested in, and that I have used or that I am using. Now, I just wanted to name off a few more that I personally have not used, but I have heard about them. So one of them is Betterment. It's a e-investment platform. I believe it costs money to invest on. I've heard good things about it from Jeff Rose. He uses it. So I believe that's an investing platform. I don't think you can trade stocks on it. I'm not 100% certain. I believe people actually do the trading for you. It's just online. And Wealthfront is another one that's like that. Now, my brother uses Wealthfront, and he really likes Wealthfront. They seem to have done pretty good for him. That's another one where he just sends them the money, and they do everything for him. It's just all online. And both of those, there are a fee because the people are doing the stuff for you. They're doing the trades for you. They're investing for you. But like I said, Wealthfront, my brother seems to really like it. And Betterment, Jeff Rose seems to like it. So, and then a couple other ones. And I believe like E-Trade, TD Ameritrade, those are trading platforms. Like I said, I've never used them, but I've heard about them and other people talk about them. And then you have some other investing platforms like Charles Schwab, Vanguard Index Funds, Fidelity Investments, Ally Invest. There are numerous other investment platforms out there that you can invest in. The thing is, just start investing. Do your due diligence. Look up these different platforms on YouTube, look up their websites, figure out what works for you, and pick a platform and start investing. That is the biggest thing. Just start investing so that your money can start compounding, because you want your money to compound. That is the number one thing out of investing. That way later on in life, you can get your finances under control, and then later on, you will be able to live the life that you've always dreamed of. And that's what it's all about. So once again, you know, thanks for watching. Welcome to my channel, 40 and Broke, where we're dedicated to getting out of debt and living the life that we always dreamed of. Once again, I ask you to subscribe to my channel, and thanks for watching. All right, bye.